nose.
The men's 100 backstroke is ready to go. The eye is drawn to the battle in the middle of the pool between Ryan Murphy, the world record holder from the United States, and the Russian rocket, Evgeny Kolesnikov. Kliment Kolesnikov, excuse me. I wonder what's going through the mind of the athletes now. It's all about the racing. Forget the times. The opportunity to win an Olympic medal is right here, right now.
Robert Glinta is in lane number 8 representing Romania. He's the European champion and national record holder.
The breakout swimmer for Spain, the 22-year-old Hugo Gonzalez, the multi-talented, the versatile European silver medal winner. He's European champion also on the 200 individual medley.
Xu in lane number 7, representing China, silver medalist from 2016 at the Olympic Games in this event. He's the current world champion.
There are two Russians in this final. Evgeny Rylov is swimming in lane 2. Olympic bronze medalist in the 200 backstroke, the world champion in the 200 backstroke, world silver medalist in the shorter 100 metres.
As we see, Chekhon come out from Italy. Thomas, he is at his first Olympic Games. He finished 17th at the World Championships in 2019, so improved into making a final.
Mitch Larkin of Australia is going to be swimming in lane 3, Olympic silver medalist in the 200, world champion in this event back in 2015.
Kolesnikov is in lane number 5, 2018 European champion. 100 freestyle European champion, so he's good on free and back. Wears a pink cap so his grandma knows which one he is in the race.
And the world record holder, Ryan Murphy of the United States, 26 years of age, is swimming in 4. He's the Olympic champion on 100 and 200 from Rio. Can he make it 2 in a row?
World record hold up. There's the pink cap of Kolesnikov. It's a tradition for his grandma. Ryan Murphy looking very intense. Going to take his time as well. Not even any of his clothing off. Everybody else is standing, waiting.
Well, remember, lane 8 and lane 1 have had a minute or so to get ready, and lane 4 has only just arrived, which is, we've seen this
for quite a while. He's using it as a tactic as well. He's taking his time.
Sure. He's earned the right to move at his own pace and have the final wait for him.
Mitch Larkin, he too, like Kaylee McEwen, withdrew from the 200 IM, didn't chase that for this 100 metres backstroke. Will the gamble pay off? Can he get on the medal podium?
The Olympic final of the men's 100 backstroke. Good reaction from Murphy, the world record holder, but the underwater's closer to us from Ku Jiu. As the middle of the pool now, the two favourites, Murphy and Kolesnikov, begin to separate themselves from the field at the first 50.
Rylov got off to a great start as well over in lane number 2. He's an Olympic medalist in the 200 backstroke. Here we go around at the 50-metre mark. Who takes the honours? It is Kolesnikov that goes around fastest, below world record pace, great underwater. As they pop up, he's still there in lane number five, leading this 100 backstroke final. 25 to go.
Rylov at the top of the screen in lane two has the 200 background, and this is Murphy. He's going to have to do something in the final 15 metres if he wants to pick up a medal, because this is about Kolesnikov, the Russian rocket. Strikes gold, and it's gold to the young. No.
He missed touch.
Again,
he didn't get his touch.
Once again, we've been confused. The final arm stroke from Kolesnikov doesn't do it, because the goal goes to Rylov across the pool. Thank you.
Four strokes under the water, under the flags, to hit the wall. Four strokes. He mistimed his touch, Kolesnikov. We'll see it in the replay. And Rylov, who is clearly behind with one stroke to go, gets on the wall by 2/100ths of a second. Wow. What a race. He was from start to finish in the hunt. Rylov, that's him at the top of the screen with the white cap, with the Russian Olympic Committee logo, on the wall with Kolesnikov. And look at this. Look at this. Left to screen. He mistouched. I'm not sure what he did.
Well, he was caught in no man's land there.
He should glide in there.
And he's taken another thing. He's gone well down on the backstroke as well. He's taking far too much time to get his hand from either hip or shoulder onto the wall.
Wow.
And that's what's cost him the gold medal. And Rylov also had a slight glide coming in, but making no mistake. And while Murphy wasn't in the conversation in the closing stages, he did enough to settle for bronze. But those 2/100ths of a second, Kolesnikov is going to look at that and wonder what might have been.
Seen great performances from outside lanes as well. It just goes to show this is a racing competition. A lane is a lane. You can win a gold from anywhere. Lane one through to eight.
History will tell you, the statistics will say, that if you want to win a gold medal at the Olympic Games, you need to be in lane four. Statistically, most of the gold medals.
Women.
Thank you. Breaststroke for women.
Oh, no.
Men's 100 backstroke.
Yes. Apologies.
The men's 100 backstroke. And again, a terrific final. Wonderfully swum, desperately close across the field. And a terrible finish from Kolesnikov as he drifted into the silver medal position behind his compatriot, Evgeny Rylov, who's in the middle there. And Ryan Murphy, the world record holder, finishing in a 52.19. His world record at 51.85. So three swimmers very close to all-time performances in this 100 backstroke. And it's a European record time to win it, 51.98 from Rylov. Hands in his pockets there for Ryan Murphy. I wonder what the body language is telling us. He doesn't really want to be third. He's well aware of the history of the event in the men's 100 metres backstroke. It's an event that the Americans have, well, dominated over decades. And Murphy doesn't want to be the one to blow the winning streak. And that's probably what's going through his mind at the moment. The rest of the world won't be thinking that.
The medal presenters are introduced. The focus on the bronze medal position. He's the Olympic champion from 2016. He settles for bronze in 2020.
We've got to go back to 1992 for the last time an American was beaten to the rostrum. That was Mark Tewksbury from Canada, who beat out Jeff Rouse, and Jeff Rouse was the world record holder at the time. Rouse then set the world record in the lead-off of the medley relay, and Rouse is the one kicking himself. But he came back 4 years later and won gold in Atlanta. Murphy will know all about this, and this is why he's looking a little bit dejected. The one in 4 years ago, 5 years ago in Rio, having to settle for third here in Tokyo.
Now for the silver medalist from the Russian Olympic Committee, Kliment, Kolesnikov.
Seems excited enough to have won Olympic silver. And it is true. These medals are so rare, you have to take one. Anyone will do. when you get the chance. He'll get the opportunities later in his career to set the world record. I don't think he's going to be worrying too much about that. This is the biggest result of his career so far. He hasn't had too many medals at the international level, at any level, let alone at the Olympic level.
He's only 21.
Well, perhaps this will be a start of a long legacy over the next 6-7 years in backstroke swimming for this wonderful talent from Russia. The Olympic gold goes to Evgeny Rylov. What a moment for him. Rylov is probably better, in truth be told, in the 200, coming down to strike gold here in the 100. He's the world champion in the 200. Already with a bronze from Rio in the 200 backstroke. The European record holder in the 200. European champion in the 200. So he's got everything to look forward to as the events unfold. But he's done the job that he had to do today. Wonderful finish, and that took gold for Rylov in a very close finish at the 100 backstroke. So we'll get a chance to hear now the national anthem for the Russian Olympic Committee. The unmistakable strains of Tchaikovsky's Piano Concerto No. 1 is being used in Tokyo 2020 for the winners of the gold medals for the Russian Olympic Committee. The three athletes coming together for the photographs. They won't be able to stay there long. Protocol will ask them to separate very quickly, and then they go on the parade around the pool deck. All smiles for the two Russian athletes. At the end of this, Rylov and Kolesnikov. And Kolesnikov has blown onto the international scene, 6 years ago or so, and dominated short course events around the Europeans and around the circuit globally. A little bit short on international major medals. And as we would discussing, perhaps this is going to be the start of a legacy of backstroke domination for the 21-year-old Russian. He's certainly got the size and the speed for it. Set European and world junior records in the 50 and the 100 and the 200, going across the distances. Can do everything. He's got great speed to be able to get to the world record, because you need a fantastic 50, pure swimming speed, just to be able to get fast enough through the 100-meter world record.
Just thinking about that 200 as well. And we've talked a lot about how the first race that you have can set the scene for the rest of your competition. And for Rylov, he certainly has a bit of momentum now, winning this 100 metres backstroke into his preferred event, the 200 backstroke.
Backstrokers tend to be the event where you see most of the swimmers doubling up 100 to 200. They do it far less in the fly, less in the 100 breaststroke to 200 breaststroke. You see more crossover in the 2 and 400 medley, especially for the women. But the backstrokes across the board, men and women, they seem to be able to double up in this.